We're seeing an improved yield out of the industrialized process. So that in turn, of course, reduces cost because you've got less waste in the manufacturing process. And then secondly, we're seeing an improved power density.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is Ilika CEO Graeme Purdy. Graeme, very good to speak with you. You've achieved another scale-up milestone for your Goliath batteries. You must be pretty chuffed with the ongoing successes.
Yeah, thanks, Stephen. Great to be back. Great announcement that we were able to make this morning. Just a couple of months ago, we were talking about the collaboration that we'd had with UKBIC, with the UK Battery Industrialisation Centre, and how we'd seen some really good quality composite electrolyte electrode structures that we'd deposited as part of that collaboration. We're updating the market today with confirmation, actually, that the batteries that we've made with those coatings actually perform better than the batteries that we made using similar materials on our pilot line. And, you know, this will give investors a lot of comfort because one of the stories you sometimes hear is, well, you know, it worked in the lab, but actually we're struggling a bit to manufacture it at scale. What we've got here is the reverse. Actually, we're seeing better performance out of the cells that we're making using the process at UKBIC.
So, I mean, obviously this underlines your confidence that the batteries on its route to markets is going to, I suppose, reduce costs, it's going to speed up charging times and also increase the range of the batteries for EVs.
Absolutely. And, you know, some of the sort of signals for those end goals that are coming out of today's announcement are, first of all, we're seeing an improved yield out of the industrialized process. So that in turn, of course, reduces cost because you've got less waste in the manufacturing process. And then secondly, we're seeing an improved power density. We're able to charge and discharge these batteries more rapidly than we were able to achieve using the prototypes that we made on our pilot line. And of course, that's giving us then that reduced charging time when you put these into an EV and you're driving on a long journey and you need to stop and top up the batteries. So those goals that you've just summarized are bang on the money.
Graeme, so this is your second announcement of work that you've done with UKBIC. The February announcement was really all about process. This one is now about performance.
Absolutely. This is all about product. And this actually, you know, wraps up that work that we've been doing with UKBIC over the past 18 months or so. That was a 2.7 million grant-funded program that was supported by the APC or Advanced Propulsion Centre. And of course, in the autumn statement, just 6 months ago, we heard that the government has pledged a further £2 billion to support the automotive electrification, the automotive transformation. And we expect, therefore, that investors will be able to benefit from ongoing support in terms of non-diluting grant funding to allow us to complete our roadmap.
Graeme, so what's next on that roadmap?
Well, exciting times. I mean, watch this space, really. Later on in the summer, we're going to be releasing our P1.5 prototypes, which are the 10 amp hour batteries that we've been building and have currently got on test. As soon as we've got a big enough data set to be able to verify the product spec sheet, the specification of those batteries, we'll start releasing them to the OEMs and tier ones that have signed up for the evaluation program that we run. And then as we go into the end of the year, we'll be releasing a second tranche of batteries, what we call our P2 prototypes, which are even bigger. There are 50 amp hour batteries. Of course, we've made a few early prototypes as part of our recently completed history Faraday Battery Challenge program. But the fruits of those endeavors are starting to be harvested.
Graeme, I hope you'll keep us updated on progress as it occurs. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Thanks, Stephen. It's a pleasure.
Graeme Purdy, the CEO of Ilika.